Okay, so I'm scrolling through social media, and I just got an ad for cat hats. I thought nobody knew about my cat hat obsession. How did they know? Before I freak out, I'm going to Georgetown University to meet a data expert who can help.
The things that get me going are solving really hard problems that affect people. So I work best when I know that the things I do are going to make life a little bit better for my daughter.
Here's some data on Natalie. She's got a pretty amazing resume, like she's worked for President Obama and the NSA. Her job? To make sure that data is being collected and used responsibly. Data collection is unavoidable because everything is data. What we buy, where we go, even...
You are data.
I am data, data is me.
So Natalie's job is to make sure that when data is collected, not if, that it's being used to help us. But sometimes data isn't used well, or it's collected in a less than super honest way.
Businesses are doing what they're supposed to do, contractually, legally. Yeah. They're telling you, I'm going to use your data, but they're telling you in a way where people probably don't even realize that they've given permission for their data to be used in certain ways.
Like, maybe I'm entering this contest to win concert tickets. I've got nothing to lose, right? Okay, so here's my name, address, phone number, so they can tell me I've won because I'm going to win, obviously. Yes, I agree to your terms and conditions, blah, 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 and submit. Wait, what are actually in those terms and conditions? Whoa, what does any of this mean? You need to be a lawyer with a lot of free time to ever understand this.
All of those words that are on that screen that you're accepting, those terms of service, that's giving them permission to use your data.
And saying I accept means you're okay with that.
How often have you actually read that thing?
That's why Natalie has conversations with lawmakers and businesses to guide data collection practices. She also talks with people like us to help us make smarter data decisions. So Natalie brought me along to meet some students who have digital privacy concerns of their own.
Hi everyone.
So this is our data dinner. So the conversation we're going to have today is really centered around, what do you think about when you're thinking about sharing your information, and how are you weighing the decision to do it in some cases and not in others?
A friend of mine was recommending that I sign up for some app that will allow me to buy things if I give the app access to my location.
The decision around that looks very different for different people. You have to give up certain pieces of information in order to get access. So it's that cost benefit, right?
Yeah.
But I have no idea, just technically, what can even be done with that data, so I'm unable to make an informed decision about whether or not to give this app access to it.
And then are you concerned at all about, like, location tracking? Like, it can track you wherever you go?
I'm unsure whether even giving permission to an app makes a difference.
So you're less concerned about that because you feel like if they want to know where I am, they're going to find me anyway, because there's thousands of ways to be able to collect information about people.
Anything that you type on a site, any transactions that you make while you're out there, that's not your data. They own that data about you.
If somebody else is taking that data and I sign something away, not reading it, and then selling it to somebody else, it's like there's this whole new, really shopping mall of people selling my data that I don't even know about.
But we still have to figure out who owns what data and how do we protect it so that we can still use it for good things while protecting our most vulnerable populations from bad things.
It's those types of decisions that we now have to make because data has become so prevalent and such a part of our lives.
Right. Data really is the way of the future. It's how the world will learn to meet our needs better. But we have to balance our personal privacy too. So next time an app asks for permission to access your photos, or a website asks who your second cousin's first grade teacher was, ask yourself, who is this information going to and why? And maybe ask a parent or a lawyer to help you read those terms and conditions. Actually, time for me to become a lawyer and a data expert. Going to school now. Be right back.